This is Ben Lang-Henriks with Genii Software with another mini lesson called Fading Frames with GIMP 2.8. In this, I'm going to show you how to make fading frames. There are a lot of ways to make frames around an image, but I want the ones that are semi-transparent, and I want to show you an easy trick. First thing I did was I created a transparent layer and set it to overlay. And now I'm going to use the gradient. Somewhat counterintuitive way, I'm going to go to the shape spherical. Okay, and now I'm going to make a gradient on the transparent image, but I'm going to pick one of the other things besides just the foreground to background. I'm going to try burning transparency, for example. And there's an interesting colorful frame. But I can also do ones that don't have any transparency. So, for example, I can take the deep sea. Because it's an overlay, it will just darken things. But if I want to go back and I want to look at what that is like with a grain merge or something like that, another overlay, I can play with these, the fading border, fading frame. See, I can invert it. I can change the hues till I find sort of roughly what I want. I can change the brightness and contrast to see how much shows in the middle. So there's a lot of playing around that you can do to try to get exactly what you want after you've made the frame. This is a standard one, but if you want just a real frame, then there's a square wooden frame you can use. And again, I do that on grain extract because it just looks a little better. But the one that I used for the cover for this video was the red tube, which is a very interesting thing to use with gradients in other uses. But this is a case of just getting a nice red-shaped three-dimensional frame. And then I'll change the color, the hues on that, because I don't really want it to be red. I want it to match better, so sort of a blue-green colorblind, so I don't know exactly what it is, but I like that look, so I'll use that right there. And I'm going to change the canvas size, just because that one leaves a little room, so I'm just going to shrink it down a little bit, and this is what I used for the cover. I just put some text on it. And there's one more thing I want to show, which is that these are all square frames, but you're not restricted to a square frame. Actually, it'll frame around whatever your selection is. So I'm going to make a funky looking frame there. And thank you. That's what it takes to make fading frames in GIMP 2.8. Thank you, and check out my other mini lessons.